I bear witness that there is nothing worthy of worship except Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his messenger. I think as all Muslims realize that this issue of banning the niqab in Belgium is just another attack on Islam, and whether it be depicting our beloved Nabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in cartoons, or whether it be attacking and invading our land, we can see that the attack on the Muslim woman's dress is just part of the wider plan. But I have a message today for the European leaders. I have a message, a warning if you like, to them. Firstly, they will never ever succeed in their plan. They will never ever be able to destroy Islam. In fact, we have been promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they indeed will be defeated. But we are ready for this. As Muslims, we should understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that Allah has many divine traditions, the Sunan Rabbaniya, and one of those is the tradition of Sunan At-Tadafu, which is the Sunnah of repelling, whereby the batil, the falsehood, will rear its ugly head in the form of democracy, in the form of freedom, in the form of attacking our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the form of invading our lands. It will rear its ugly head in the form of an attack on the Muslim woman and her dress. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create a situation where the haqq and the people who carry the truth, they will rise above the falsehood, and the truth will prevail, and it will repel the falsehood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that he will throw the truth against the falsehood, and the falsehood will perish. So we are ready, and you European leaders, you want to challenge the Muslim woman, but be warned that a Muslim woman's honor is something that will be protected at all costs. So you should be careful, you are playing with fire. You may ban the niqab, you may even ban the hijab, al-khimar and jilbab, but you should know that you are fighting a losing battle, because no Muslim woman wore her niqab because even Lamateh, he said that they could. No woman ever wore her khimar and jilbab because Sarkozy said she could or he permitted it. No woman dresses the way we do because David Cameron said she can. We dress the way we do as an act of submission to our Creator, and we will never stop obeying our Lord. We will always dress like this, whether you like it or not, whether Jack Straw feels uncomfortable with a veiled woman or not, whether Sarkozy thinks it's an oppression of it's a symbol of oppression or not. We will continue to do this. And that, you know, the other thing is that we get fed up of hearing, I'm sure the sisters here today, that we're oppressed. We hear this all the time, that the Muslim woman is oppressed. Well, let them hear my voice. We are not oppressed. We submit to the Creator alone. We do not submit to the dictates of fashion or society or the desires of man, woman, president, any politician. If you ask me, the women who walk the streets half naked, the European streets, they are oppressed. They are oppressed with all the men ogling at them. If you ask me, it's the men and women who are exploited for their sexuality when they're spread across the billboards of Europe for capitalist gain. They are the people that are oppressed. The only oppression I feel as a Muslim woman, and I'm sure my sisters and brothers will agree here, the only oppression we feel is the oppression of man-made rule. That is the greatest oppression. We live in a society that is riddled with oppression. If you look around us, you've got pornography, rape, paedophilia, adultery, alcohol abuse, drug abuse, poverty. I could go on and on. This is oppression. We also feel oppressed by these governments when they invade our lands, when they raid our homes and arrest our husbands, when they kill my brothers and sisters in Muslim lands. That is oppression to us. So that was just a short message from one Muslim woman, but there are thousands, hundreds of thousands of women like me across the world and across Europe who will make a stand, and we will never ever remove our Islamic dress ever. So you have a war on your hands, and if that's what you wanted, that's what you asked for. This is a short address to my sisters in Belgium and in France. We see your struggle. We feel your pain, and we share this fight. We stand by you, shoulder to shoulder, proclaiming this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never will we let them dishonor the women. Never will we let them remove our hijab and disrespect us. Just like the Muslims of the past, we will stand shoulder to shoulder, side by side, proclaiming the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it supreme over the whole earth. Sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, O you who believe, if you obey those who disbelieve, they will turn you back on your heels, and you will turn back from faith as losers. Never turn back from faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has
promised us victory and we will inshallah have victory. Stand strong, stand side by side and we will have that victory inshallah.